Hi, this is Dr. A with a medical terminology video on the pathology of the integumentary system. All right, we're going to start with the pathology of the skin. So an abscess is a collection of pus in the skin. Acne is an inflammation of the sebaceous glands and the hair follicles with papules and pustules. So usually there's pus involved with acne. Acne rosacea is a chronic form of adult acne with redness and tiny pimples, and they're primarily on the nose. Acne vulgaris is a common form of teenage acne with comedos, which are blackheads, papules, and pustules. There's pus, usually is kind of all over the face. Albinism is a genetic condition in which the skin is unable to make melanin. The skin, hair are both white, and the eyes appear red. Basal cell carcinoma is a cancerous tumor in the basal cell layer, which is the cell that is making the new skin cells. And it is a common cancer that rarely metastasizes, meaning it rarely spreads beyond the skin. A burn is skin damage that is caused by fire, electricity, ultraviolet light, or caustic chemicals. The percentage of skin burn is estimated using the rule of nines, which we're going to look at. So the way you do the rule of nines is you divide up the body into 10 areas that all count for 9%, and then the groin area counts for 1%. And so all that together makes 100% of the body. So in front, the front part of the face is 4.5%. Back part is 4.5%, so together the whole head is 9%. Front of the thorax is the chest here is 9%, and the back area here is 9%. The abdominal area front is 9%. The abdominal area back is 9% also. So, you know, chest and abdomen then would be 18%, or if it was chest, front, and back, it would be 18%. The front of an arm is 4.5%, the back of an arm is 4.5%, so each limb there then is 9%, right? And then the front of a leg is 9%, and the back of a leg is 9%, so each leg would be 18%. So there you go. It's a quick way to be able to estimate then, you know, how much of and the surface area of a person has sustained burns. Cellulitis is a diffuse acute infection of connective tissue of the skin. So it's deeper than a layer of the skin. It goes down deep into even sometimes into the muscle and stuff. So it's a deep infection of the skin. A cicatrix is a normal scar. A decubitus ulcer, or a decube, is an open sore that's caused by pressure over bony prominences. It is caused by the loss of blood flow to the skin. It is often referred to as a bed sore, and people get them from laying in the same position in the bed for too long. Dermatitis is the inflammation of the skin, and dermatosis is the presence of a skin condition. Dry gangrene is the late stages of gangrene. The affected area becomes dried, blackened, and shriveled, which means it's dead or dying. Eczema is a superficial dermatitis with redness, vesicles, itching, and crusting. It often has an allergy component to it. And interestingly, there's a lot of food sensitivities that are tied to eczema. Gangrene is tissue necrosis or death due to the loss of blood flow to an area. Ichthyosis is when the skin becomes dry, scaly, and keratinized, which is hardened. Impetigo is a highly infectious bacterial infection with pustules that rupture and crust over. Kaposi sarcoma is a skin cancer that is seen in AIDS patients with brownish purple lesions. A keloid is a thick hypertrophic scar. Some people do those on purpose as decorative, so they scar themselves in certain shapes, and then there's a lot of tissue in that scar, right? Keratosis is a condition of excessive growth and thickening of the epidermis layer. A laceration is a torn or a jagged wound. A malignant melanoma is a dangerous form of skin cancer. It begins in the melanocytes and it quickly metastasizes and spreads to the rest of the body. Pediculosis is a lice infestation. Psoriasis is a chronic inflammatory condition with these papules. So these are raised areas that form silvery scale patches. And so it's actually excessive skin growth, skin patches that become dry. And like I said, that's where the silvery scale, it's like a xeroderma. It is an autoimmune condition. Rubella is a contagious viral infection, also referred to as the German measles. Scabies is a skin disease that is caused by a mite infestation. Sebaceous cyst is a sebum-filled sac under the skin. Squamous cell carcinoma is a cancer of the epidermis layer. It may invade the deeper tissue and metastasize. A strawberry hemangioma is a congenital collection of dilated blood vessels, is also known as a birthmark. It usually has a reddish color to it. Systemic lupus erythematosus is another autoimmune disease. It is a chronic disease of connective tissue. So it's an autoimmune disease where your immune system attacks the connective tissue. It injures the skin, the joints, the kidneys, and it produces a red, scaly butterfly rash that usually is across the nose, and this is where it gets the lupus, or think the carnival wolf mask that, you know, goes like that over the eyes. Well, the rash mimics that because it's like across the nose and the cheeks there. Tinea is a fungal infection with itching and scaling lesions. Tinea capitis is a fungal infection on the scalp called, and it's usually commonly referred to as ringworm. You can also get it on the skin, and it is referred to as ringworm. There's not a worm involved in that. It's just because it's raised and round, it kind of looks like it might be one, but there's not. Tinea pedis is a fungal infection of the foot, also known as athlete's foot. Varicella is a contagious viral infection, also known as chickenpox. And verruca is a wart, which is a benign growth caused by a virus. Actually, human papillomavirus, HPV, causes most of the warts. Vitiligo is a disappearance of the pigment from the skin in patches, and it causes milk-white lesions on the skin. And I may not be pronouncing that one correctly, so if you hear of a different, better pronunciation, please go with that. And then wet gangrene is an area of gangrene with a secondary bacterial infection in pus, so it precedes the dry gangrene that we talked about. Okay, so now we're going to talk about the pathology of the hair for this slide. Alopecia is absence of or loss of hair, is baldness. But usually when we talk about alopecia as in with the hair loss and the baldness, it's actually an autoimmune condition also. Carbuncle is a furuncle involving several hair follicles, and a furuncle is a bacterial infection of the hair follicle with redness, pain, and swelling, also referred to as a boil. So if there's one is a furuncle, if it's several, it's together is a carbuncle. Trichomycosis is a fungal infection of the hair. And then the last slide is the pathology of the nails. Onychia is an infected nail bed. Onychomycosis is a fungal infection of the nail. Onychophagia is nail biting, and paronychia is an infection of the skin fold around, which para means around or besides the nail. So there you go. That wraps up our pathology terms for the integumentary system. Thank you for your attention.